this.
That's the way, Charlie. Take it slow. Slow and easy.
I didn't scare you, did I?
You jerk, you idiot!
Hey,
what
sis,
do you think you're doing?
Hey, come on, don't get mad. Just protecting my hooch. You know nothing out there is really gonna hurt ya.
Fine, let go of me now.
Depends. Monsoon over?
David, let go.
I'm sorry. I don't mean to rattle your cage.
Help me pick up the groceries.
It's getting kind of desperate around here. I ran out of cookies 3 days ago. Did you bring any of my favorite?
Now, David Cutler has walked through hell and come out alive. His sister Heather's done her best to help him, but even sisters have limits. Heather's come to David's hooch to talk about limits. And hell is about to be redefined.
I put on 10 pounds just looking at those things.
You're too paranoid, kiddo. You're missing
all the best things in life. I know.
Still read my mind, huh? Like when we were kids.
I used to know everything you were thinking. Before.
Ah, come on, have one. Old Marty won't divorce you for a few extra pounds.
David, there's more to life than just cookies. When's the last time you went out? You left this place, met some people.
Unfriendly country, sis. This is my hooch. It's safe here.
The war's over. It's been over for a long time. You can't hide here anymore. Mom and Dad are gone, and I have a life to live, too. I don't want to start a family in a one-bedroom apartment. I'm selling the house.
Marty put you up to this, didn't he?
This isn't fair. You know, you're not the only one that has problems. It hasn't been easy for either of us. Both Marty and I decided that this would be the best thing. Not only for us, but for you. You could have a life, and maybe this is the very
thing
that...
This is my life. This house. The memories. We grew up here. It's safe here. Don't you understand that?
David, I have tried to understand. But it's not my fault what happened to you. It's time to move on.
I can't leave. I can't. You don't know what it's like out there, what might happen.
I'm sorry. I've made up my mind. And you're just going to have to accept it. Look, there's going to be an open house this weekend. So I think it would be best if you came to stay with us just until the house is sold. And then we'll help you find a place of your own, okay? I want you to start packing up your things. Most of it can be left here. So just bring along what you need, okay? David. I have to go. I'll be back on Friday. Please be ready. Maybe I should have told him sooner. Given him more time to adjust to the idea, I don't know.
You've given him 10 years already, honey. You can't keep your life on hold anymore. I know it's tough. Once he's out of that house, it's going to be easier for him and for us.
I don't know.
Honey, trust me. We're going to be able to have everything we've always wanted. A good home, a good neighborhood, and room to raise a family. Huh? You'll see.
I guess you're right.
And we'll be able to make a down payment on that house you liked.
You mean the Tudor one?
Yeah, the Tudor one. You remember that? With the 3 bedrooms. One for the morning, one for the afternoon, one for the night.
Let it ring.
Might be the agent about the open house. Hello? Hello? Anybody there?
We speak to Heather.
David? She's in the shower. Can I take a message? David? Are you there, buddy?
I won't leave this house, Marty.
David, listen. This has got to be. It's the best way, so let's not have any trouble, all right?
It means a lot to Heather.
I can't go.
David, you're being...
What is it? What did he say?
He's not gonna leave.
I knew it. I knew he'd never leave.
The hell he won't. He's getting out of there one way or the other.
What are you doing?
Calling a lawyer. It's your house. David's trespassing.
Martin.
So let the law take care
of this.
There's
gotta be another way.
Believe me, it's the only way. You have to show him you're serious.
I don't think this is a very good idea. I really don't.
David's flaky, but he's not stupid. Once he sees a score, he'll leave.
David? It's us! Are you ready to go?
Come on, David, let's do this the easy way. You know it's Heather's house, and you have no legal right to be here, so let's just avoid any trouble. David! I know you're there!
David.
Now take it easy. Put the rifle down, slow.
No, let me talk to him.
Heather, don't.
The rifle. Now.
This is my hooch, sis.
David.
I can't leave it.
No!
Call an ambulance!
David.
It's okay. Everything's okay.
It's empty.
Why, David? Why?
It's the only way.
Right. Right. I see. All right. No, we'll be in. Okay. Oh, thanks a lot. Bye. He's still the same. He'll call us if there's any change. But we probably won't know until morning. Look, it wasn't our fault. It was a stupid thing to do. That's the way he is. That's why you wanted him out of there.
Just shot her for no reason.
What? Who are you talking about? David?
The woman. They just shot her because they didn't know who else to shoot. No idea. I can't take this anymore. I'm not strong like you. David, please.
Vicko! Vicko! My Vicko!
Stop it!
My Vicko!
He's just a boy!
Thank you.
I see, David. I know.
Now take it easy. Put the rifle down slowly.
No, wait, let me talk to him.
Heather,
put the rifle down now.
This is my hooch, sis.
I can't leave.
Heather! It's me! I just saw David. He's fine. They say he's gonna be released by the end of the week.
That's the way, Charlie. Slow and easy.
Heather! Please!
Heather heard about hell, but she never really saw it, felt it. Now she's home again and hell is far away. Or maybe it's as close as her own front door.